Hello, doctor.
Hi, Shabanu.
How are you, doctor?
I'm fine.
I hope you are always fine.
Thank you.
Welcome. Hi, doctor.
Hi, how are you?
Victoria, Tony.
Tony Bachman. Yeah, hi, how are you? Okay. Hello, Navar.
Hello, sir.
Hi. Now from now you are, I think you all have been informed that Tuesday you will have a quiz, okay? And by the way, it's a quiz, yeah. It's not that difficult.
Doctor,
But
the quiz will be on chapter 1 and 2.
chapter 1 and 2, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
And one question.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
It's one question, and I think I sent you the assignment. It means that you should upload your answer that in that location. Okay, and I think I wrote to you the rubric. Okay, either.
Sir,
Sure.
is the quiz gonna be on Tuesday?
Yes. Yes.
So is it going to be on cl at class time or?
At the same, yeah. In
Okay.
the mean class time, okay?
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay.
Sir,
Yes.
could you give us more time because it's only 50 minutes. How can we upload our question and this stuff? Could you?
Okay, yeah, we will start. So you have 1 hour. This is all. So Tuesday we will not take any classes. So basically you have a time for doing that. Okay, if you need more time, we will think about it and maybe I add you or give you some more time.
Okay, so
Hi,
we'll have
sir.
1 hour time.
I'm sorry, yes.
We'll have
Sir.
1 hour.
Shabanu, we have yeah, it's the sorry, just 1 minute. The quiz is for 15 minutes, and I may give you some other 10 minutes to upload the answers. Okay, so it's 25 to 30 minutes. Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, I'm sorry. Who was
Sorry,
that?
sir.
Yeah.
Me, Yad, and Dahlia, we are at uni doing our design project, so we might come to class a bit late today.
Today?
Yes, so like now we're doing our design project, so we can't come to
Now
class.
you are in the campus.
Yes.
So yeah, good. Take your time, take care. Okay.
Okay, and
And
you will
whenever
record
you
the
have
class, right?
done, yeah, whenever you have done, so you are most welcome.
Okay, thank you. So, thank you very much.
Let's start our lecture for today. Today we are going to take an advance another step. So before that, let me remind you that what we have taken in the before, we took here's the process of yeah. Here's the process of how the water is going to be delivered after what we all calculated, we calculated the population have been forecasted for the next design period, and also the fire demand has been calculated, and then we have the peak flow on the maximum and the average flow and the relation between them. And we said we are going to take the maximum monthly in the design of the intake, right? The pipelines, we have two things to add. We have minimum, we have maximum monthly demand, and of course the average. And we say that usually the number of the pipes are more than one, and we will take the velocity equal to one, and from the maximum monthly, we will check for the velocities and so on. So we are here now. And this is the water resources, this is the in pipe intake, and this is what the sump. And the main criteria, the main basic design criteria we used in design of the sump was we should have not more detention time than 2 minutes or than 5 minutes, right? So either we have Q maximum and with the 2 minutes, and we will check the volume, or Q minimum with the 5 minutes, and we will check the volume, and we will take the maximum, take max, maximum volume to design the sump, right? And then after that, we will have low lift pumps. Low lift pumps are basically depend on the efficiencies of the motor and the efficiencies of the tank and the Q maximum. It means the horsepower that we need, and also we have the difference between this the first treatment unit. Here, the first treatment unit is sedimentation tank. And you think this is the dash line. The dash line, it means that we have a long, long distance between the low lift pump station and the first treatment. And just to remind you that we have maybe in 4 to 5 or 10 kilometers distance between the low lift pump station, because it's exactly on the river, and the sedimentation tank or all treatment plant should be in a safe and a safe area. The safe area means, I mean, that it should be far away from the flood, far away from the those area that's not, we are not allowed to build everything or nothing in it. So that's why we put a dash line. Then we will start, we started a sedimentation tank. We say that we have two types of the sedimentation tank, right? Who's there? Let's start with Miran. Miran, can you hear me?
Yes, doctor.
We have two types of tanks, right? We have either it will be what in shape?
Sorry, doctor, I didn't hear you.
The tank, the sedimentation tank, the clarifiers that we are going to treat water from it. We okay. have two types, right?
Okay.
We have two types. Which and which? Based on the shape, we remember that I'm talking about the shape of the sedimentation tank of the clarifiers. We said that we have two types, which and which. We have.
Doctor, can I?
Yes, Prisha.
Sump. One of them is sump.
The sump, yeah. The sump was the first one. We have done with the sump. The pipeline we. Done, and the low lift pump also the location of the pump. So we send water from the low lift pump to the first treatment unit. The first treatment unit, which we say that it's to remove, it's for settling the solid particles. And we say there is an equation for that, which is the Stokes velocity, or Vs, which is equal to 1 over 18 g over mu rho s minus rho d particle square, and we say there is something else which is called SOR, surface overflow rate. Remember that? And where's the SOR? SOR is equal to Q over A, right? Now, it's now the type of the clarifiers that we have two types. Either it will be rectangular tank, right, Miran? Okay, or
it or will circular.
Be, or circular. And we have different idea. We have for rectangular tank, for circular tanks, we have SOR, they should be, then when we are using SOR, it will be between 10 into 60 meter cube per meter square per day. Okay, and the time that this, the 1 meter cube for water is spent in here in this tank is between 1 to 8 hours. So this is the time or the time that need. Okay, and we have different, and I solved to you a problem, how to design a circular tank or rectangular tank based on that. And also we say that we have a wheel loading, right? Wheel loading is what? Is a Q divided by, who's there? Ares?
The cross-section area?
Ares, yeah. Yes. Okay, yeah, you are right, but it's not that cross-section area.
The WH?
W? H. Yeah, wheel loading. The wheel loading, it means the wheel, the load of the Q divided by, this is the Q, the pipe is, yeah, this is the tank. And this tank, there is a flow, and we say that this flow after treating will escape to this trench, right? So the length of the trench is called the weir.
Weir length.
Weir length of the weir, or weir of that, which is equal to pi d, right? So Q divided that pi d, it's called weir loading. So that weir loading should not be more than, I think it's 100 to 250, like all these
ones.
Sorry,
I have a question. When we found the weir loading and it's not in the range,
yes,
redesign the
you want to check this one, and you everything was correct, the dimension was correct, and just you have an issue in the weir loading, right? So to solve that, you have to look about usually. We will face this kind of problems when we have a rectangular tank, by the way. I will, for the circular way, the usually is the length will be okay, satisfy. If it's not satisfied, so this wheel loading, this is the L, which was not satisfied, I have to increase the wheel. You know what is that wheel? It's a trench. It's a trench and it's suspended. So I can increase, let me say I can add more weirs like this, I can more weirs like this, and the water will also go inside these weirs, so I will add more L's. Then all these weirs are, all these trends, by the way, their length should be added to the original L, and in this way we will get that's fine. If and by the way, this is for circular are seldom to be happen. For the rectangular, yes, for the rectangular, we will face usually this kind of problem. We have a queue. This is the top view, by the way. We have a flow in this tank, and we should usually we will put the weir here, and the water will be clarified and get in this trench. And this trench, this is the L, and it will not be enough. Then we will get, we should take from the edge of the tank other, I will, it means that I can add trench here, another trench here, so that the water can go out from the other sides, right? If it was not enough, I will add another one here. If it was not enough, and I will add, so these are, they will be added, and their length should be added to the original L, and then the Q divided by the all weirs loading will give you a satisfied weir load. Okay, Ares? Now
yes,
we have,
thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Now, this is what in the past, so today's lecture is about what after that. What after that, usually we will, the sedimentation And by the way, it's a long story. It's a very, we have books on segmentation, but it's enough for us to take only a review and an image how they will work. After segmentation, the whole particles, you remember that we say that we have particles that will be removed 100%, right? Those particles, we say that this is, we have the particles, it's denoted by D naught, or sometimes they say it's the 100%. While we have any particles or any solid matter is less than this, will have a probability. There is no guarantee to be settled 100%. It may be a settled 50%. It may be it's less than one. So why it's not settling? Because it's smaller in diameter, right? Then they are not, they are very smaller in diameter and they will still in suspension, not to be removed. They are so small. So they are not be settled. What to do? I'm just adding a little bit chemicals, a little chemicals to them. Add chemicals, some chemicals. So that chemical will make will act as a glue. As a glue, and it will make a kind of, and by the way, those chemical I will flash them in a very, let me say for first 30 seconds, half a minute, and then leave them to make a kind of higher or make it so greater in volume, greater in weight masses. So I will get other masses. So the all we will have another masses, which are they are their molecules are combined together. And in this way, what I did, I just added more material to those who are in suspension. So due to the and binding between the molecules, so they will make a solid. This is called flock. So they have a higher in value, they have higher in weight. Then after that, there will be definitely the settlement. Then I resettled those particles which are, they were in suspension. And what I did, I added some kind of chemicals to them. Here, the adding of those chemical material is called coagulant. Coagulants are chemicals. Chemicals, I added them to react, to act, to collect all the suspicious materials to make a bigger mass bigger in weight and resuspension. So coagulants, and it's a kind bit difficult to read coagulant. Who can read it? Can you read this word? Andesha? Can you read this one? Hello, Andesha. Arina? Could you repeat this word?
Coagulant,
yes. And the action verb is coagulation, right? Okay, coagulant, coagulation. Aris?
Coagulants?
Okay. And the verb or the name is coagulation, okay? Burwa?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry. What is that word again?
Coagulant, coagulation.
Good. And what is the effect of them? The main effect of coagulant or those chemicals is to add them and to make a bigger mass. The bigger mass is called flock. It's called flock. And the action is called flocculation. Okay. Nevar?
Yes, sir.
Could you just repeat this word again for me?
Flocculation.
Flocculation.
Yeah.
Flocculation. And what is the flock is? the flock is
inside the
kind of mass, a big mass of so those who are those particles, those solid matters which are still in suspension, and they don't want to be settled, so we are enforcing them to be settled. Again, so the process is coagulation and flocculation, and now you know the sequence of the process. The sequence is, first of all, we will have to add the chemicals. And by the way, this is sometimes on in the beginning of the winter, you see that we have the tap water is has a kind of yellow color. That's because we add they add more than the needed quantity, the more than the needed quantity of those chemicals. And by the way, the chemicals are called alum. So alum is a chemical, and as I say, it's a coagulant. It's added in a certain, it should be in a certain dose that let the suspension to be accumulated, to be agglomerated, and so on. What is that alum? This is the alum in terms of chemical. This is the trade name, and it's Al2SO4XH2O. And X, it's a molecular, it's sometimes between 10 to 18, the difference. So Al2SO4, okay, this is a kind of salt. And when we add this salt to the water, aluminum will add, will agglomerate or make the suspension and will cause AlOH by 3, which is called, this is will be settled. This is, and by the way, if it was in extra doses, it will affect of our skin, and sometimes it accelerate the hair dropping.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Sir, we do add aluminum sulfate to the clarifiers, right?
So yeah, we will add them, but in a separate way. It's not in the same clarifier. We will prepare that one because this is in a solid state. Let me show it to you. Just
okay, sir, minute. But why do we do that? So that we have suspension in the clarifiers?
Because already the clarifiers was designed to settle the particles, and we say this detent, and still there is still some smaller in size particles. They still don't want to remove. So what to do? We have to enforce them when we
by adding this salt
chemical, this kind of salt, and we do add them, and this is make flocks, and the flocks are a mass of collected suspended particle, heavier in weight, and then they will be enforced and settled. But this process will be in a set and another tank, not in the same tank.
So this is what we said.
This is the coagulant that we added, and as I said, this is Al2SO4 XH2O, which is called alum, and in Kurdish it's called zakh, and this is forming. The process will be look like this. Now there are flocks. The flocks are greater in size, so they will be definitely settled. These are the okay. Yes.
Shall we use the coagulant for any types of diameters except for 101, the 100 diameter? So we have to use for all types of diameter.
Yeah, usually when we, the process is, first of all, we have to be aware. This is sedimentation tank or clarifier. We will see after this what we have. This is inflow and this is outflow, right? So the outflow, we will have to test if whether the water is clean or not. Then we will add, based on this test, we will add some chemicals, them alone. to these tanks and let the water with the alum to be in another tank, and this another tank will help to make the settling of the flux again. The alum and the other chemicals that we are using, they are designed to settle the suspended solid small particles, okay? Because the others, the rest, the high in diameters particles are already, they will be settled by the effect of what we call it, gravity, okay? Is that clear for you?
Yes, thank you.
Now, we have, as I said, we have alum, and this is the chemical composition of that one. Definitely, we have more than one materials. And by the way, for Suleimania, we are using this one. And we are using, this is, by the way, it's not very expensive, but we have polyelectrolyte, which is very, very expensive, but this is will give you 99.99% like what we have in the elections, removal for the suspended particle. While this one is not giving you that much, and if you have, here's the alum, look at this one, it's like a sugar, like a salt. So this is the alum, and by the way, polyelectrolyte is look like a glue. And it's very, it's transparent. And you have to be aware, it's not smell good. And so here's the principles that we are using. Some of the countries are using ferric chloride, FeCl, or ferric sulfate, FeSO4, or ferric sulfate or ferrous, sometimes Fe2 and sometimes Fe3 and so on. And look at this one, sometimes they are in crystals, it means it's in solid state. This is also solid, this is in powder or solution. Solution, it means that we can do it in liquid. And sometimes we have the alum are in the lumps or powders, okay? Now, the flocculation is the process that after we added, and remember that what I told you, that we need a detention time. We need a tank, a small tank, like what we are, when in your house you are doing a yogurt, you need to have just make a quick flash mixing, right? Also here, we need a small tank, and this small tank is called flash mixer. Just we have impeller here, we have impeller that's making to mix the coagulant that's coming here, and I will send to another tank. So this is called flash mixer, and the flash mixer we have only just to add chemicals. And by the way, we should prepare. Because as I told you, the crystal in the alum is in a solid state. So we need to make it in solution. We have to add some kind of water, and then, but it will be concentrated. Then I will add like a small tap to be here. I will add it to the queue that's coming from the low lift pump, and then make a flash mix in here just to be mixing. Then, and then I will send it to another tank to just make it settle down. And that another tank is called flocculation tank or flocculation. Just want to remind you that, okay, we add chemicals, right? So we add chemicals, and the chemicals are to remove the suspended materials, the suspended particle, right? Let's think what are the suspended materials maybe include. May include clay, they may include salt, they may include colloidal, may include sand, or microorganisms like algae, fungi, bacteria, viruses, pathogens, protozoa, or sometimes we have dissolved impurities like salts, gaseous, organic matters. All these are existed in the suspended, here's the suspended, like at this one, the suspended materials that we have. So adding chemicals is to remove about 99.9 from these materials, from the silt, from the clay, from the sand, from the microorganism that we have. So all these should be removed from after that, what we have, after what we have done with the sedimentation tank, with the those particles are in suspension. Okay. So we want to remove them. We add chemicals in a coagulation period, and we say this is chemicals, and be aware that the chemicals are very sensitive to what? Because now we are leaving the reaction of that chemical with the materials in water. So remember, this is a chemical, and any chemical reaction, chemical reaction will depend, or maybe faster, or maybe slower, or maybe dependent on the temperature that we have. Maybe in the summer, it's not, it, we have to add less chemicals that we have in the winter. Also, the pH value, the origin of the water that we have, the alkalinity of the water. Alkalinity, it means that the material, the water is having minerals inside in it or not. So sometimes the quality, if the water is having very good quality, bad quality, and so on. So these are the main factors that will help us to select the coagulant, and the coagulant is, as I told you, and we here in Slovenia, we are using both alum, and we are using polyelectrolyte. But the problem is, sometimes we don't have technician. The technician, they don't know how to measure the quantity. They don't know how much grams or milligrams they have to put it in the tank of water so that the reaction will be made. So we don't have a flow meter because we want to know how much is the Q that we need to add the chemicals to. These are our problems. And again, we have another problem that we are, some of the after Dukan, we have Kirdijoka, we have other tanks. Also, they are going to add more chemicals to the tanks. They think that, okay, today is the water is very turbid. Turbid, it means not clean. Turbid water. So what to do? I'm just adding some extra alum. How much do you want extra alum? Okay, put half a gallon. Put, let me say, that much lump sum of the alum and leave it for 3 hours, 4 hours, and then send it to the houses. That will make a problem to the populations. And by the way, let me say how can we as an engineer, or let me in base of a scientific base, how to add how much it needs? I will give you a short, there is an experiment. Experiment, it's called turbidity, or let me say jar test. Jar test. This jar test, it depends. I will take 1 liter, 6, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We have 6 jars, it means container. I will take 1 liter of water from the same, from the source. And I will put it in these jars contains, and I will add different doses. milligrams. Let me see, I will add here one, I will add two, I will add three, four, five, 6 milligrams of the alum. They are from the same source. And I added different doses for everyone. And they are having, there is a mixer for each of them. I will start mixing these jars to make a solution to be and soluted in these jars for 30 seconds. And after that, I will wait and I will wait for 25 minutes and I will see, is there any residual in the bottom of the tank or it's clear? So I will check. Whenever that we don't have residual, or let me say that it's clean, it means that the total, I don't want to very be clean and I don't want to have very settlement here. The very settlement here, it means that we have extra chemicals and this extra chemicals make more flux, which cannot be, it's useless, it's extra. So I have to, let me say the number 3 was very good. So I will ask them to have to add 3 grams per 1 liter of water. And then I know the Q, how much meter cube per hour that they have. So converting this one to a meter cube, I will know how much kilograms should I have per hour. And by the way, if the, I have to let the water to be in the tank for 3 hours, so directly I will know how much kilograms should I have, should I put. And this test should be done in the site for at least 2 times per day. 2 times per day we have to do it, adding coagulants, because this is a chemicals, we have to be aware. The typical concentration to be added here is we have between 5 to 15. By the way, in Slemania, in the highest peak value, when we have in the seldom winter turbid water, they used not more than 15 milligrams per liter. But in Baghdad and the other parts, they are exceeding even 50 milligrams per liter. Okay. Do you understand me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, it is. Thank you.
I don't know how much the time is it?
It's 5:26.
Okay. I will not go for the... I'll just give you a review on an idea how to design. Now we are, this is the principles and this is the scientific base. Now we are, as an engineer, we want to know how it's our responsibility to design such kind of tank, to have this kind of flash mixer. So flash mixer, it means that you have a small tank, you need to design, we need to design a small tank like this. There is a Q in, the Q is coming from a clarifier, and we'll get in this one, and I have an impeller motor, and this is make a mixing, and it's go out to the another tank, which is called flocculant. So here we have not more than 30 seconds we need. So we have the Q times the 30 second, we will get the volume of this tank and it's called volume of the coagulation tank. And here we have about 30 minutes to 45 minutes. And also we have the Q and we will multiply this one by the volume and we'll select the clarifier. What remains? Remain, we have here flash mixers of flash, let me say motor, impeller. We need to know how much motor, how much pumps that we need. This is, should be done with using this equation. It's called gradient, it's called gradient velocity, G. It depends on the volume of the tank, viscosity of the water and the power, how much power that we need. And basically that she has arranged. This is for the flash mixer. We have arranged 4G. It's about 50 to 1000 second power one, because power is the units will give you J gradient velocity in per second. P is the power that this motor need to be just making that flash mixing, and V is the volume, and U is the viscosity. So these are the design parameters that we need for having the flash mixer. And also, and this is called flash mixer or rapid mixer. After that, we will go to the to this kind. So this is, yeah, after adding the chemicals in a very rapid way, and then the chemicals start mixing with the water, I will send the mixed whole water with the chemicals to another tank. Here's the another tank, it's called flocculator. And the flocculator, it's the process of making more flocks or growing up the flock in size. Also, they look like what we have in air coolers. We have puddles, and these puddles should act slowly. We'll make more flocks. And then after that, and sometimes the puddles are in this way. Sometimes we have them in this way. So it's all about how to grow up the flocks that we have and make them big in size. And you can see all the materials here are made from wood, because we have chemicals, and these chemicals are corrosive. So we were, and by the way, even the concrete that's used in this kind of structures, it should be solvent resistant. And the solvent resistant is higher than the normal concrete in price. That's what we have for today. Next lecture, we will start solving how to find the volume of the coagulation tank, how to find the for power for the motors that we need for having such kind of coagulation tank, and also for the flocculation tank and for the flocculator. If you have any question, I'm ready to answer you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Is it clear?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I have a question about the chapter 2.
Yes.
In the equation that we have to find the soaring velocity.
Settling velocity. Yes.
No, the one we found for the checking.
Scouring. Scouring velocity.
Scouring velocity.
Yeah. In okay, the equation. It should, horizontal velocity should be less than the scouring velocity. You know why?
To let the particles settle in the bottom of the...
The articles now, they are after, let me say, after a duration, after a rest of 8 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, right? We put them in a tank, we cage them, and then all the particles removed. Now, there will be a current. There will be the water is coming, and they have a current. This current should not be more than a specific amount to resuspend those settled particles again. This is why we have called a scouring velocity. We don't need them again to be resuspended, right?
Yes.
Okay. So and this is the philosophy behind of the velocity should not be, and usually this is the resuspension will come from the horizontal velocity. The horizontal velocity will act on the surface of those that are settling, so they make them again to be resettled, and that's why what we don't need them to be happen.
Yes, but in when you write the equation in the slide, there isn't any 8 in the equation, but when you solve the question, there is an 8 inside the square root.
Just yeah, there's a request. Just let me see. Question two. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Let me share with you this one. You mean this one?
I think it's the last slide.
Yeah. Before this, I think it's before this. It's about when it's sedimentation. Yeah, it's yeah, after that. Yeah.
Last slide.
The last. Yeah, this is the settling velocity. You mean this one?
Yes.
Yeah, this one.
Yes. Okay. There isn't any 8 in the equation, but when we solve the question, there's an 8.
Yeah. Now, B, I think for the B, we will use how much? It depends, 0.04 for unregant. Let me say 0.04, right? And for the frictions, we need 0.02, right?
Yes.
So 0.02 to 0.04, it means let me say I will use 0.02. Okay?
Yes.
And now we have G is 9.81, right?
Yes.
Okay, so maybe we have, so let me think, B is 0.04, yes, 0.02. And it's equal to 2 times 9 is 18.81. Yeah, I think it's not 8, it's 18.
No, if you could please go to the question.
Yeah, this one.
Yes, I think it's...
This is 18. No, it's after that, maybe this one?
No.
Okay.
Sir, I think it's the last slide. Yeah, here. It's
yeah.
8 times 9.81.
Yeah. So this 9.81 times G.
Yes. That is the B over F.
Now the 9, that's 2 times
yes.
8. Okay, so B over F is, we say that it's 0.04, divided 0.02, right?
Yes.
So it's 2, so this is the 2.
Yes.
Okay, G, so I think, yeah, this is 8 is maybe X. So I have to check it. Good, thank you. I will check it. I think this is should not be here.
I tried to find it in the book and I couldn't find it.
Yeah, the book, let me check it. Yeah, we will check it again. Okay, just give me 1 minute. Water supply. Water supply, yes, this is water supply. I think this is in chapter 5. I remember it's in chapter 5. Yeah, here is it. You checked it in the textbook?
No, I couldn't find it.
Yeah, I think it's here. Yeah, here's the scour velocity, by the way. Yes, there is 8, you know?
Yes, there is an 8.
Yeah, this is 8. So 8 beta over F S minus 1 G D power 1 over 2, okay? And V, let me check with this one. What we have it here, let me take this here. Can see?
Yes.
So it's 8. Yeah, there is an 8, you know. GD, yeah, GD is there. And divided by F, it's there. So I missed, I think, yeah. So that, yeah, there is an 8. So the answer is correct, but I missed to put here 8.
And before, in the slide that you explained,
you have to add, this is, there's an 8, yeah. Here's, we have 8. Now it's correct, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Who was that?
Me, Aris.
Aris, thank you, Aris. So now we have 8, B beta over F, G, D, S, now this is correct. And so the solution is correct. And this is the original, this is the reference.
Sir, could you update us with the right one?
This one? Okay, I will add you.
Thank you.
Okay, let me add them to this one. Any other question? Thank you very much. Any other question? Thanks. Okay, take your time and take care. See you next Tuesday.
Sir?
Okay. Yes?
Can I have one question about the quiz?
Yes.
Is it all like we covered from the beginning of the semester till now, or is it a particular chapter we have to focus on?
The chapter 1, chapter 2, yeah. It's about... by the way, we did. I gave you about the fire demand and the population forecasting in the assignment. Remember that?
Yeah, I know that. But we emailed you. No, you said that.
I think it will not. I will not bring any question from that one again because it will be repetitive. So after that, so population forecasting and. Water demand will not be covered, will not be included for that one. But I want you just have a review because I need you to have a review for the midterm. So it's better to rewrite, just focus about the second chapter.
Chapter 2.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.
Have a good day.
Yeah, bye-bye.